Circling back to the topic of prophecies brought about by the efforts to avoid them, I think I can recall such a story as you mentioned, brother. A Greek tale for the stage. Rather lurid, but very popular. You know the one?
Every Greek knows the tragedy of the Theban king.
Yeah, word gets around about that sort of thing. Something else I recall about that Greek play I mentioned, if you won't take offense to the critique. As a work of performance, it consisted almost...
Prepare for a fight.
Run!
Another berserker gravestone.
Father,
Speak, spirit.
Is that... Father, I can't see you. I wasn't quick enough. I'm so sorry I abandoned you.
Your father is dead.
What? How?
He went to find the other treasure on his own, to spare you the dangers.
It seems that in your efforts to protect one another, you each came to one of these islands on your own, and...
I've been such a fool. But... thank you for telling me. Perhaps now, we can see each other again.
What a shame.
In their attempt to spare the other, they both perished. There is a lesson there.
What now?
We will retrieve the treasure, then return to the father.
What for?
To finish what he and his son started.
That water wheel's getting no water. I see. The geyser under the water wheel is blocked. Something appears to be atop that island.
Perhaps the treasure the spirit spoke of.
We could use that lift, but not while it's up there.
Stop squirming.
You did it, Master Kratos! A spectacular job! Keep it up and you'll become an expert in no time!
I can't tell if he was patronizing or if that was just plain sad.
Both.
gate is down, but it has to stay there.
About to explode!
Incoming right side!
Quite the cache. I see why it meant so much to our lost treasure seekers. Perhaps we should go tell the father what became of his son.
Rock's riddle. The answer
is. Gather the fear!
For later!
Welcome!
Man. You've got that.
Thanks for helping us. Yeah.
Riddle. Could the answer be nothing?
What gets bigger the more you take away? Nothing. I don't think so, brother.
I do not like riddles.
Back.
We have news of your son.
Oh, please, tell me.
He died trying to find the other treasure. He didn't know you were doing the same.
No, no, no. This is my fault.
He disobeyed your wishes.
Yes, because that is what sons do. I should have brought him with me. We'd be alive and rich beyond all reason. Together.
Don't blame yourself. He is at peace.
Nevertheless, thank you for finding him. I'll seek him out in Helheim.
I'm glad we did this, Kratos.
Yes.
And I'm sure Atreus will be as well.
Yes.
Brother, you don't like riddles, eh?
No.
Oh, you just haven't heard any good ones. Here, I'm tall when I'm young, short when I'm old.
What a candle.
Yeah. Heard that one before?
No.
Oh. Well, did you like it?
No.
Headed back to the city? I came by and took out an Einherjar patrol. Area should be clear. Can't speak for the rest of town.
Guess an occupying army is as good as a lockdown for tamping down foot traffic.
I hope you're back to clean up the mess that extra head of yours made.
We have done it.
Doesn't fix what I did, but hopefully it makes things a bit better. Let's be off, brother.
Your hammer.
Thanks. Might not mean much with Odin's goons stomping around the city, but folks see this and they'll know we haven't completely given up. Not yet. Never expected to see this thing again.
Durlan.
Kratos! Sorry about earlier. Talking about you off like that.
Do not be.
No, let me apologize. Feeling the old father's spear in your back makes a man want to set things right.
Your silence on the matter is enough.
If you say so.
You spoke of resistance. Instead, you drink.
Oh, I've got plans that you know nothing about. Coming together as we speak. Meantime, I don't plan on my soul parts floating to Alfheim stone cold sober. When the Aesir run me through, I'd rather be too hammered to feel it.
You are staring.
You're a tough man not to stare at. If the dwarves had your strength, Odin would have never gotten as far with this place as he did.
My strength has little to do with my body.
Yeah, sure.
Durlan?
Who are you to thank for the newfound fresh air sliding up our nostrils?
We turned off the mining rigs.
So you did. Let's pretend you did so in a manner consistent with the 97-part safety regulations handbook written specifically for the operation, maintenance, and deactivation of said mining equipment.
Do what you will.
Well, thanks anyway. Means a lot.
Fancy a riddle?
If you fancy a boot to the head.
Riddle solved. Suppose more violence in the streets will convince the citizenry that it's safe to emerge. Brother, somewhere out there there's a riddle you'd enjoy, and I'm going to find it.
Do not.
Once spoken, instantly broken. What am I?
Silence.
Correct!
I was not answering the riddle.
Ah.
Flower.
Sparkthorn.
Wait! No! Brock has to be the one to tell me what happened. I'm just gonna pretend I was over here. I knew we'd left something behind. Amazing. After all my time away, there is truly nothing I missed about this place. Want something in particular? Whatever you need, I'll create. And now, Freya? Does this work? Please say yes. Need something?
try not to break it. You again. You know, you're the reason Odin's thugs are marching around the city.
We're killing all the Einherjar we can find, if that's any consolation.
Whoa, whoa! How about we just take that outside? This is a peace-loving establishment.
Now that you have a weapon to deal with Heimdall, we just need to find a way to get to him.
Aye, if that's still the plan.
It is. I will protect my son.
So, then it seems the original plan to avoid Ragnarok has fallen a bit by the wayside.
That is up to Odin.
Yes, that's rather what concerns me. Listen, brother. Those things he said to you...
His words are nothing.
True. Though I expect retaliation is no empty threat. We need to think through the ins and outs of it.
You're getting ahead of yourself. Let's see if Sindri has had any luck.
Good to see the chimes working as intended.
Here's what I found.
What a rambunctious bunch!
Seems we met another of your detachable emotional apparitions. Bit too twitchy to tell us his name, though.
Ah, you must mean anxiety.
Oh no. Why are you talking about me? What did I do?
Oh, you should have heard the shit they were talking. Savage.
What? Oh dear, oh dear.
There was no such talk. Shame on you, Bitter.
Are you sure?
Yes, Anxious. No opprobrium to be found in this discourse. I was merely making your acquaintance with our adventuring friends here.
Ah! People!
Well, there it is. Until we meet again.
Do you not understand when a conversation is over?
Show off the spear. See what we done. Now do the thing.
Oh, look at that. She's special, that one.
Ain't gotta tell me.
Have you found a way to reach Asgard?
Not as such. Had a few ideas, but they didn't so much work.
Brother, without a way to Asgard, what are we doing?
I do not know. I need to think. I am tired.
So, you're sure nothing unusual happened with the lady? Nothing at all?
Nothing whatever. Smooth as snail shit, like I said. Why? Is there some reason you expected it to flip sideways?
What? No, no, of course not. I'm delighted to hear everything proceeded as planned.
Well, they did. And it was a proper adventure to boot. I taught them all about the nature of the thing and the form of the thing. Become a whole motif.
You're making up words again.
I said it was a motif, and it was beautiful.
You are impossible.
I'm the most possible one around here.
I guess we'll have to come at this another way. You look terrible. Get some rest.
Where are you going, brother?
Sleep.
So we're just keeping blindly on then, hoping we don't walk headlong into Ragnarok. Is that your plan?
You all right? Well, your father seems very ready to go. Shall we then? This way, Grumbles. You enjoy the gentle waves, little one. Your father and I traverse this river often. One day, you will learn to navigate its waters. We live deep in the wild ones. The most beautiful forest in all of Midgard. And it is safe and serene here. Game is plentiful, and you will want for nothing. We're not far from the place your father and I first met. We nearly took each other's heads off. But he's softened since then. Somewhat. Unfortunately for you, he remains dreadfully stoic. I suppose it will fall to me to teach you language. Your father can teach you to hunt. Or perhaps that will fall to me as well, since all he seems to be good for is grunting. Have you nothing to say to your son?
Do you have me say, Faye?
Anything. Let him learn your voice. Let him know you.
He is far better off knowing as little as possible.
Knowledge is not always a burden. Think. The mighty god of war. Frightened of his own child.
I do not fear our child, Faye. I fear for him. He is innocent.
We are not our failures. We are not who we were. We must be better. Atreus is our future. Keep him safe, Kratos. Protect our son.
What did that wall ever do to you?
Building focus. Something my father taught me.
Did it work?
Not yet.
So, what you focusing on anyway?
Controlling my emotions. Heimdall keeps trying to make me lose my cool. I can't give into it.
Through. It's true. Hey, be cool.
Training without me?
that a good idea? Training? I mean, I think it's a great idea, but won't your mom be mad if she finds out?
Good point. But did you consider?
No, I didn't. That didn't hurt, also. Mm-hmm.
Anyways, Grandfather wants to see you.
Oh, Grandfather. Right, okay. Here, then take this. And, send my regards to Sif, Lady Sif, and Atreus. See you later. And Thrud. Bye, Thrud.
Midgardian boys are so weird.
Weird can be good.
The two of you, I swear.
What's in the jar?
Milk curd. Mom's favorite. It's his way of helping. Grandfather's in the study. Catch up later?